Thank you, Ian, and very, very pleased to be here. My name's Kimball Riley, CEO of Vista Group. Really pleased to be here to talk about our company and about our results for the first half of 2022. The first thing I want to talk about is who we are and why we're here. Our purpose is to bring more people together to experience the magic of movies and cinema by creating the platform that connects the industry, empowers the moviegoer experience. That's our purpose. Who are we? We're a global technology company delivering mission-critical solutions to the world's leading cinemas and studios. Our market is the film industry globally. We have customers in over 100 countries, and our global market share of the enterprise cinema space is over 50%, excluding China. To give you a sense of the scale of the business, over a billion tickets are transacted through systems that are powered by Vista technology every year. I want to talk about our strategy, but in doing so, I need to provide some context. The majority of our cinema customers are deployed in an on-premises environment. One of our major projects, in fact, the largest project our company has ever undertaken, is to re-platform our technology to a cloud SaaS platform future, which is the project which has been occupying us for the last couple of years and will continue as we keep working through the development. Our strategies, therefore, are reasonably simple. First of all, we support our customers and support their success. Second key strategy is moving our customers to our cloud platform, where we can contribute more directly to their success and where we can create the kind of connections across the industry that we believe will deliver real value in the future. Thirdly, we continue to seek opportunities in the wider film industry, right, primarily working with our portfolio companies. Our strategies are delivering, as you'll see when I talk you through our first half results. In so doing, the first thing I want to talk about is our industry, and then I'll talk about our company. We see moviegoer sentiment as having recovered and box office growth following. Just to be clear what we mean there, people are going back to the cinema to watch movies in big numbers. Box office growth is following on from there. Some highlights for us in 2022 so far. Blockbusters, clearly. Top Gun: Maverick, Jurassic Park: Dominion, and Doctor Strange in the Multiverse have all done over $1 billion at the global box office. Depending on the country, box office revenues are running at between 70% and 95% of peak pre-pandemic levels. That box office is coming from relatively fewer movies, so the average box office per movie is actually ahead of pre-pandemic times. Per cap, which is the industry expression for spend per patron, is also well up, in some cases by more than 40%. As can be seen from the paraphrased quote from the CEO of Warner Discovery, the value of the theatrical experience and of an exclusive theatrical window is now clear and well established across the industry. The majority of cinema operators around the world are reporting results much improved over the last 2 years and showing that they can grow revenues and EBITDA. We'd also highlight that there's a good opportunity for further improvement, primarily through the quantity of content that is released into the cinema space. We're seeing terrific interest in our Vista Cloud platform with a very active sales pipeline, and this is in part driven by the relevance of our digital offering there as moviegoers change gears and purchase online as opposed to the point of sale they might have done in the past. As you can see, the feedback from our initial cloud customers has been extremely positive. I'm only going to touch very briefly on our financial results. Suffice to say, we're very happy with our overall revenue up 39%, most particularly with recurring revenue up 43%, and recurring revenue, therefore, 86% of our total revenue, which has been a real focus for us. Underlying EBITDA, when corrected for expected credit loss and bad debts, has improved over the comparative prior period, and our operating cash flow remains positive. We've used a modest portion of our cash during these last 6 months to make specific investment decisions to expand our market share and continue the engineering of our platform. At June 30, we had net cash on our balance sheet of over $30 million, and we will continue to be extremely disciplined in our financial management. I've talked about our Vista Cloud project, the largest our company has ever undertaken. As I say, we still have some way to go, but we're beginning to see early signs of the fruits of our endeavors. 2022 so far has been a collection of really significant milestones for us. We've ticked off 6 months of smooth running for our first cloud customer and just recently completed the implementation for our second. We've learned an enormous amount from both projects, and we have delivered a beautiful customer-focused product which sets us apart from our competition. We've signed up and begun implementation for by far our largest cloud customer to date, and customer feedback on the implementations has been very positive both for the product and also for the teams doing the work. Once our first three customers are all implemented, which will be in all likelihood during 2023, we'll have just over 400 cinema sites running on the platform, representing 8% of our installed base. We have achieved feature parity with our on-premises product, by which I mean anything that you can do in an on-premises implementation, you can do in the cloud implementation. And we have a very strong roadmap for the engineering we need to do to continue to make the process of implementing and managing much easier, because right now we're not satisfied with the level of effort we need to deploy to implement and manage. I want to talk about the industry outlook a little bit further, right, in terms of looking ahead. You've heard me say that movie-going sentiment has recovered and box office growth is following, but there is still ample scope for continued improvement, as I said, primarily through the quantity of content. To give you a piece of context around that, in a typical year pre-pandemic, there would be 150 movies released into the US or North American market. The rate today is around about 90, so there's still significant scope there, right? All studios have recognized the value of the theatrical big screen experience and of an exclusive theatrical window. And we're seeing moviegoers reacting really positively in terms of showing up to watch that content. Blockbusters, as I've said, have been very, very strong. And two in particular have reached into the top five all-time box office list for North America, being Spider-Man No Way Home and Top Gun Maverick. And the slate for later in 2022 and into 2023 looks like compelling viewing. We've included here a summary of some of the key elements of that content, with some of the more niche content that you'll be able to see coming through, bringing a broader range of moviegoers into the cinema. We couldn't fit everything on the slide. We had to select what we thought was the most important movie each week, but you can see a really full range of content coming through. For those of you who are keen moviegoers, and I hope there's a whole lot of you who are, the Flix app, which comes from our portfolio company Flix, is an outstanding way of being able to figure out what to watch and where to watch it. Looking a bit further ahead, we've included here a global entertainment and media outlook produced by PwC. This is their forecast for global box office over the period 2017 through 2026. They're predicting that box office will return to 2019 levels in 2023. Regardless of exactly how it plays out, we believe this forecast underlines our perspective that our industry is on track and yet still has lots of room to keep improving. I'm really, really pleased with our strong first half result the team have delivered in 2022, and I'm looking forward to a continuation of the same for the balance of the year. We're expecting to deliver total revenue of between 123 million and 128 million New Zealand dollars, driven by our focus on recurring revenue and assisted by our purchase of Retriever earlier in the year. This represents an upgrade of $5 million on our earlier forecast. We're aiming to sustain positive operating cash flow through the year, as I said again, with investment primarily in our cloud platform. We're aiming to sustain positive, the interest from our customers for our Vista Cloud platform is growing all the time. It's a really exciting future for us there, as we see customers absolutely want to move in droves across there, right? And us being able to deliver commercial outcomes which are ahead of our initial predictions. I believe we're in a terrific position. Our industry, film and cinema, is thriving, albeit still with room to continue improving. Our customers are operating at pretty much full speed, and we're seeing a terrific response around our cloud platform focus. I believe that we will look back at this time as pivotal in the history of the company, emerging in great shape from the pandemic, still with good hard work to do, but with a tremendous future. So I thank you for your time today, and I believe we are now over to going to questions.